Emergency medicine in Australia has only been around for the last 40. And what do? Well, we're the front door to the hospital. We see patients, we treat their symptoms, we diagnose, we resuscitate, and we act as the safety net for the healthcare system.
Hi, I'm Associate Professor Viet Tran. I'm an emergency physician at the Royal Hobart Hospital, chair of the Tasmanian ED Network, board member for the Emergency Medicine Foundation, chair of the Australasian College for Emergency Medicine Research Committee, and co-chair of the Tasmanian Health Senate. There are many ways to get into emergency medicine as a specialty career. I'm reminded by one of my gastroenterology consultants when I was a student, actually, in terms of what to do when you want to choose a career. And he told me that what you need to do is understand what the specialty consultants do, because what the junior doctors do in that specialty are quite different to what the specialists do. And the other thing that was even more important was trying to understand what the bread and butter of that specialty is, because some people will go into maybe emergency medicine or retrieval for all the adrenaline-fueled work that they do and the high intensity, but it's actually what you do day to day that's the most important when you're choosing that specialty. And for me, emergency medicine offered the bread and butter of emergency medicine offered that that variability, as well as the teamwork and collaboration that I didn't really find with any other specialties, especially coming in as a consultant and working with that team to help patients. And I think from a patient point of view, that was the other drawing factor for me in emergency medicine, was the fact that patients that present to the emergency department present there because they don't feel like they have anywhere else that they can go, that can provide them with help, which is why they come to us, and we're a 24-hour open door service. And so they offer us the opportunity and the ability to treat them, and I personally take it as a responsibility to be able to offer them the help that they need so that they can get better. So when I started as the Director of Emergency Medicine Research with the Tasmanian Department of Health in 2019, there wasn't much happening in the space of emergency medicine and for research. And in particular, if you think about it, emergency medicine as a specialty is actually quite young. We're one of the youngest specialties internationally, and in fact, some countries still don't see emergency medicine as a specialty in its own right, unlike things like cardiology, where they've got 400 years ahead of us in terms of being a specialty and having the research infrastructure and the research to go with it. So when you have a look at research for emergency medicine, we're still in our infancy and we're still trying to find our feet. And certainly that's the case within Tasmania as well. And so what we found was to be able to enhance our research footprint, that we would collaborate, and we have collaborated nationally to enable us to tap into some of that research that's happening in emergency medicine around Australia. The two big ones that we've been collaborating with that's really helped launch emergency medicine research in Tasmania has been through the Predict Network with Professor Simon Craig, who has been instrumental in helping to foster that research infrastructure in Tasmania, as well as through the National COVID Research for AD with the help of the Alfred Emergency Department, led by Associate Professor Gerard O'Reilly, has been the other big factor with regards to building our research capacity in Tasmania so that we can fulfill the requirements to deliver high quality patient care. The current biggest study that we're involved in is an MRFF study looking at the implementation of clinical pathways in Tasmania. That's an MRFF grant over 5 years, of which we are currently into our second year. The premise of the research for this grant is around the fact that we know that roughly it takes about 17 years to get evidence developed at the bench side or published in papers to get to the actual bedside and actual patient care. It takes about 17 years. And what we wanted to do is understand how we could reduce that time from research publication to actual impact at the patient bedside. And to do this, we thought that emergency medicine has a different flavour when it comes to research. We have high patient numbers. We have we hopefully only see them for a short period of time, and we often don't have that opportunity for follow-up as well. And so what we found that is that with clinical pathways, we could potentially utilise that better to minimise the variation in patient care, ensure that any health inequities are minimised, such as rural and regional ED settings, and trying to understand why pathways may or may not be used effectively from that point of view as well. The reason why this all started in the first place was the fact that we found, and this is internationally, that perhaps clinical pathways perhaps aren't used as often as we would like them to be used, and therefore that introduces variation in care, and it certainly introduces some safety concerns as well if we're not following the right pathways within our own evidence-based practice. And in Tasmania, what we found is that perhaps around 10% of pathways were being used, which raises the question of what's happening with the other 90%, but even more so, why are we only using it 10% of the time? And so our research is looking at the why, but also developing an implementation toolkit to increase that uptake of clinical pathways so that every patient in Tasmania can have the same standard of care regardless of which ED they turn up to. And hopefully with the lessons learned from our projects, we'll be able to teach other sites with similar sizes and similar patient cohorts how to effectively implement pathways and other projects in their jurisdictions as well. For me, emergency medicine research forms one of the four key pillars to delivering high quality patient care. These pillars are research, education, quality, and safety. And so with research, what you have is being able to answer how or what high quality care is. The education is about how many people can deliver it, whereas quality is about how systems can deliver what the research has shown. And then safety is about how systems can minimise the harm provided if the right context isn't applied for application of that research. And so for me, my journey started in education and quality and safety, and it quickly was obvious that it was not a stable platform to deliver that high quality care that I've been in pursuit of. And so by understanding the research side of things and developing the research and essentially the research impact has really fostered my passion to enhance not only research capabilities, but research understanding and evidence-based understanding for all clinicians, both within emergency medicine and without.
The trauma workshop is a two-day workshop for final year medical students and paramedicine students to really get involved and hands-on with regards to what they need in terms of skills for managing trauma. We know that these guys are going to be our junior doctor and paramedicine people next year, and what we really want is to enable them and provide them with the skills so that they can work alongside us to provide high quality care for the patients of Tasmania if they are unfortunate enough to come to the ED following a trauma. What's unique about this workshop is that
to have the research impact that I want and that the community should get, it's important that we we complement all four of those pillars in terms of research, education, quality and safety. And so for me, doing the research and finding the proof is not enough. It's about research impact in terms of doing the hard work and then getting it to a point where it does improve patient care. And so for me, education has been critical to this role of research impact. So once we've found the research, or once the research has been developed and created and is out there for everyone to see, then we need to somehow understand how we can incorporate that research into evidence-based high-quality care. And through education, I've found a passion to be able to distill this research and all the research that's out there to be able to pass on this information to both medical students, junior doctors, as well as my consultant colleagues as well. Some of the highlights with regards to delivering this education has been things like the University of Tasmania Trauma Weekend, which is a two-day intensive workshop for final year medical students from across Tasmania to be able to understand trauma systems and how to look after patients in that acute trauma setting using the best evidence available. Emergency medicine is a very chaotic and team-based specialty, and it's certainly not for everyone with the shift work and all of the ED overcrowding and personalities that exist around it. If it's something that you are interested in, I'd highly recommend that you seek a mentor who is an emergency medicine physician. And the key here is that for anyone that's worked in an emergency department before is that for every emergency medicine specialist, you will get at least 10 or 15 different personalities in that one room. And that's the beauty of emergency medicine, is that you can have your own personality and you can bring your own unique flavor to the specialty. And so what I would recommend is that you find someone or a mentor with a similar personality to your own, or someone that you aspire to, and seek their help with regards to developing your own emergency medicine strategy in order to get onto the program, but also be effective within the emergency medicine program and be an effective member of the emergency medicine leadership team as a consultant.